Hi, I'm Steve Cotter with a brand new Give Me 10 workout. This workout is going to be using exclusively kettlebells, and it's going to be a 10-minute continuous circuit. Now, if you haven't used kettlebells before, just a couple quick tips. First of all, as far as footwear, I recommend Olympic weightlifting shoes because they offer a lot of stability, especially when you do overhead lifts such as the press and squatting. However, if you don't have Olympic lifting shoes, any flat-soled shoe will work, or even barefoot. What you don't want is to use a very soft-heeled running shoe because that will absorb too much impact through the ground. Another thing to keep in mind is in the beginning, the kettlebells may put a lot of pressure on your forearms, so I recommend just wearing some wristbands so that you can give yourself a little bit of a cushion. For you ladies that are brand new to kettlebells, I recommend that you start with an 8-kilogram kettlebell, which is going to be about 18 pounds, so somewhere between a 15 and a 20-pound kettlebell. More experienced women can use a 12-kilogram kettlebell, which is about 25 pounds, and very advanced women athletes can use a 16-kilogram, which is about a 35-pound kettlebell. But ideally, you want to just select a weight that is challenging for you and gives you a very good muscular and cardiorespiratory workout, but at the same time enables you to finish the entire workout without stopping. So the last thing that you're going to need is some kind of timer. You can set a clock, or you can use what I like to use is a gym boss, where we can just set the interval so that it beeps at the end of every interval. And for this Give Me 10 workout, it's going to be 10 minutes, and each exercise is going to be either 30 seconds or 1 minute. So I'm setting this timer so that it beeps after every 30 seconds. And I'm going to be doing the workout with a 20-kilogram kettlebell, which is 45 pounds. And I'm going to use this type of kettlebell, which is called a kettlebell sport kettlebell. But you also can use this type of kettlebell, which is more of a standard or a classic kettlebell. These are better quality, but they're also more expensive. Any kettlebell that you have will work for this particular series. Okay, the first exercise is going to be a two-hand swing, and that's going to be a 30-second warm-up, and begin. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Keep your chest up. Straighten the legs at the top. Now you're going to hold the kettlebells with two hands and you're going to do a squat. Squatting down and standing up. Inhale down, exhale up. Next exercise is a one-hand swing. Swing it behind you. And again, keep your low back flat, chest up. You're going to do 30 seconds each hand. Switch hands. By now your heart rate's really racing. Next exercise is a press. Bring it to the chest and it sits on your hand and press, straightening the arm at the top and letting it down. Two breaths. And keep the kettlebell aligned over your feet. Now you go at your own pace. If you need to slow down, you take a few seconds and you switch hands. Or you can go faster if you're in better condition. Next is a lunge, alternating legs with a figure eight. So step back and pass the kettlebells from one leg to the other, from one hand to the other. It's a bit of a coordination movement. You're also toning the hips and quads. Now we go back to a swing. This time you switch hands with every repetition. Stand up tall each time. Fully extend the legs and hips. Now we come to a push press, like a press, but you use your legs. You bend, now use your legs and press. Bend and push. Switch hands, push press, 30 seconds.